Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're going to look at some updates to Publish to Web that were really interesting, and also just talk about how you can make that work better for you. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Publish to Web. I know you've heard Patrick and I kind of caution you on Publish to Web, and that caution is real. Just be aware that data in Publish to Web is not secure. It is just open and available for everyone. So make sure you're not actually putting sensitive company information out on the internet. Right? We don't want to do that. But there are some great uses for Publish to Web. Some great examples. One is the Microsoft Investor page, where they actually show the earnings from a, you know, just an investor portfolio perspective. Those are financial information that a company has to disclose. That's a great use of Publish to Web. Another great use of Publish to Web is like a report about health and the COVID-19 scenario around the world, right? So that information is a great use of Publish to Web. It's just publicly available data to help people explore and learn more about what's going on. And also in the United States, we're having our elections come up this year, and election data is also a key area where Publish to Web is a great use of data to understand what's happening with that election in different areas, from all the way from federal to state to local communities. Publish to Web is great for that use case. With that, there are some updates that came out. I was actually pretty surprised about this because Publish to Web has kind of just been what it is for a long time. And one of the things that you're going to see here is that there is a focus on just making this a better experience, really. What I want to do is walk through. There's a blog post. I'll have a link for it down in the description below that Łukasz Pawłowski published that talked about these updates. And I just want to walk you through some of them to bring you up to speed on what's available, and also to maybe take another look. If you're using Publish to Web, take another look, maybe streamline it a little bit, and just, you know, bring it up to date. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my computer to see what this looks like. So I'm looking at a report here. This is my standard AdventureWorks report. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and generate a Publish to Web token for this. So let's go to Publish to Web. We're going to go to Share, Embed Report, Publish to Web. One thing you're going to notice right out of the gate is that the dialogue has been updated. When I did this, I was a little shocked. Normally, it was just the embed code, like the links in the HTML area that was displayed for you. Now we actually get a preview of the report, what it's going to look like. You've got options for sizes, so you can pick what these are. This is just going to update the width and height and the iframe code, but it's nice to be able to just pick that from a drop-down box. That's nice. The bigger thing here is this placeholder image. And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to upload an image. We're going to do a placeholder. And so this placeholder image, what it does is it basically gives you this option. So it's going to host the image and then allows the user to view the interactive content. And this image could be whatever you want. Maybe asking yourself, why do I even care about that? There are some scenarios where if you have a busy web page where the browser's trying to do a lot of things, where this placeholder image can help with that perceived performance. If it's just the placeholder image, that report's gonna come up really fast. Whereas if you've got a lot of visuals, plus the web page is doing a lot of other stuff, there may be some reasons where, like, look, that takes a long time. So having the placeholder image there lets the page come up faster and lets your user experience just be better. So this is something to consider if you're noticing there's maybe a little lag there. Try out the placeholder image and see if that helps with some of that end user experience. And then once they click on that view interactive content, then it will just go into the actual report. The other thing you can do now is actually set the default page. It used to be whatever the first page was, that's what's coming up, and you didn't have any control over that. And so now it's nice that you can just set whatever that default page is that you want. I'm gonna copy the iframe code to the clipboard, and then we're going to close. So now that's set, and I have created a little page here. So we'll go ahead, Publish to Web report. I added the iframe code to it. Go ahead and refresh it, see what it looks like. And now we see we get this standalone image first, this placeholder image. And then what I can do is I can say view interactive content that takes me to the report, which is great. That's bananas. Like, that actually is really cool. I love that. Some other things that are coming, they're not available in the service just yet, but they're going to be there very soon, is for data refreshes. So one of the problems with Publish to Web was there was this 60-minute or 1-hour delay on when it would actually update items that are there. So when your visuals issue a query or anything goes and queries the data set, that query's cached and it only gets updated every hour. If you do a refresh, may not be reflected for an hour or so after, depending on when that next cycle is going to come in for the cached queries. That could get pretty annoying, especially if you have some information that you need up to date. Maybe it's a news article or something of that nature where, look, you need it to be updated. So one of the changes they announced is they're actually, once you refresh an imported data set, it will actually clear the cache so that that data is available immediately, which is great. However, if you have a high number of users or you're doing things in your report that aren't generally best practice, so maybe you've got a ton of visuals on the page, you may end up encountering this high usage, I'll call it a throttle. And what'll happen is that in that case, if you don't have a placeholder image, you'll actually see an image saying, hey, this report's under high load, you need to come back. If you do have a placeholder image, it will show the placeholder image and then it'll have a message on the top that says, hey, you're under high load. The blog post calls out that this is rare, but it can happen, especially if it's something like the election night, right? Everyone's going to want to go to see that data. You're probably going to have high load on it at that point in time. So if you know that that's going to happen or you're worried that it might be, just take some care in your report design. Make sure you've followed those best practices. I'll have a link in the description below also to the guidance documentation on the Power BI documentation site. There's a ton of great information in there that can help you to streamline both your data set and your visuals. Remember, reduce the number of visuals, be smart about your data, keep things simple as you can. For a published web report, I don't know that detailed data is gonna be the best use of a published web report, whereas generally it's more aggregated data, so you can see trends and things of that nature. Just be aware, be thoughtful, and take your Power BI published to web report to the next level. All right, I wanna hand this over to you. What do you think? Are you using published to web? Are these improvements kind of exciting? Or do they change how you're gonna use published to web? Let me know in the comments below. I wanna hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.